congregation, they are being categorized as being fasiq. Fasiq. They are fasiq. And who are those that say that they are fasiq? You have Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Az-Zuhri, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, and one narration of Imam Ahmad. أَحَدُ رِوَايَتَيْنِ عَنْ أَحْمَدْ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ الْجَمِيعِ. And one of the narration, or one of the points, or one of the position of Imam Ahmad, may Allah have mercy upon all of them. All of them, they say what? That such an individual is a fasiq. طيب. نعم. He died 124. So he was, yes, closer to him. And actually, Imam Az-Zuhri, rahimahullah.
He's the one that, I don't want to say started, but.
No, he was from the first compilers. Actually, the ulama, they mentioned, after Bukhari and Muslim, which is bil ittifaq, right, the most correct books after the book of Allah, those two books, and there is no ikhtilaf in regard to that, except, right, we talk about in Ahlul Sunnah, there is none. Imam Az-Zuhri rahimahullah comes third. Imam Az-Zuhri Muhammad ibn Muslim, he comes third. And he was from the first compilers. Imam Az-Zuhri rahimahullah died 124. Compiler meaning those who recorded the hadith, right? They recorded the hadith in one book, right? Well, qawlu thani. So we are talking about the second statement, the second position. What was the first position?
Fisq.
Fisq of who?
The individual is abandoning salah and laziness for knowing.
Right, the person abandoning the salah out of laziness. But while believing that he is, the salah is an obligation. Right? مَعَ إِقْرَارِهِ بِوُجُوبِهَا. While believing and affirming the obligation of the salah. طيب. So, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Az-Zuhri, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, and one of the narration from Imam Ahmad, they all say that this person is a fasiq. وَالْعِيَّاذُ بِاللَّهِ. الْقَوْلُ الثَّانِي. The second statement. The second statement. أَنَّهُ كَافِر. The second position is that the person abandoning the salah out of laziness while believing in its obligation. A second group of the ulama, they say he is a disbeliever. وَقَدْ اتَّفَقَ الْجَمِيعَ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ يُسْتَتَابْ ثَلَاثًا. He say that the second position is that he is a disbeliever. And we'll come to who are those that say that. And they are all in agreement that he is to be given the opportunity to repent, that they will tell him to repent. Ala annahu yustatab thalathan. They will give him three opportunities to repent. Like the jahil, remember, like the person that is ignorant. When will be the person that is ignorant asked to repent? When? When is it that we ask the person that is ignorant asked to repent? Na'am. Very good. بعد البيان له. After clarifying it for him. Right? After clarifying it for him. So he mentioned أنه كافر. The second position or the second statement is that he is a kafir. Shaykh Ubayd al-Jabir حفظه الله, he's telling us about the second position of the scholars. رحمهم الله الجميع. He mentioned that they say that he is, the person is a disbeliever. وَقَدْ اتَّفَقَ الْجَمِيعُ that the people, that they have a consensus, meaning they have a consensus in regard to أَنَّهُ يُسْتَتَاب, that he is to be asked to repent ثَلَاثًا three times. كَالْجَاهِلِ, as it is being asked to the jahil, the ignorant, to ask to repent to Allah. فَإِن تَابَ, if he repent, alhamdulillah. وَإِلَّا قُتِلْ, if he doesn't repent, he is to be taken out. He doesn't repent, he is not to be, he is to be taken out. Right? Now if a person, لا قدر الله, his son, decide not to pray. Right? He say, listen man, I'm not praying. Even juhudan, even if he is disbelieving in the obligation of it, is he, because he's his father, is he to be taken out? لا. هذا الأمر يرجع إلى من؟ أولو الأمر. That matter goes back. It is the responsibility of what? Of the أولو الأمر. And as inshallah we will come to study بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى, those things that are from the responsibilities that are incumbent only upon the أولو الأمر. Nobody is to be doing it but the Muslim ruler. Not you, not me, not Fulan, not Allah, only the Muslim ruler is to be doing it. Like those iqamatul hujjah, ma'adhir, iqamatul hudud, establishing the capital punishment. Only the Muslim ruler is to be doing it. Nobody else. Nobody else, barakallahu fi. Naam, so he mentioned hafidhahullah. He say, wa illa qutil, if he doesn't repent, he will be, he is to be killed. And he mentioned that he is to be, it is to be asked, he is to be asked to repent thalathan, three times. Kal jahil, as the jahil, the ignorant one is to be asked to repent. Fa in taba wa illa qutil, if he repent, alhamdulillah, fa biha wa ni'am. But if he does not, he is to be killed. Illa abi hanifata. So they all agree that he is to be asked to repent. If he repents, alhamdulillah. If he doesn't repent, that he is to be killed. Except Abu Hanifa. He is the only one that say he is not to be killed. But look what he say. He say, قَالَ يُحْبَس. يُحْبَس. Number one. He is to be, barakallahu fikum, beaten. He gotta whoop him. That's the word, right? وَيُعْذِرْ, and he is to be, barakallahu fikum, secluded or jailed. حَتَّى يُصَلِّي أَوْ يَمُوت, up until he is dead or he start praying. So he is to be jailed and to be punished until, meaning to be lashed and jailed and lashed, until he prayed or he dies. Tayyib, he is the only one to say that he is not to be killed.
Now I was going to talk
about Fadal, it's a point.
The point of the some of the Muslim cultures, they do the honor killings.
The honor?
Those honor killings. Like if their daughter commits zina, they'll dispatch their sons to go kill her, or Things like this, or marries outside of the tribe. Or
Subhanallah, of it.
In Algeria,
Allah al-Musta'an. This is not permissible, barakallahu fiqh. Those, it is only to be established by the Muslim ruler. It is only for establishing any had, any capital punishment. It is only done by the Muslim ruler. Nobody else. And the Muslim ruler, barakallahu fiqh, he is not just gonna just jump from he say, she say, and just establish the had. La. He will do what? A thorough interrogation. A thorough investigation. Before, barakallahu fikum, bringing about what? About the had. Right? Before bringing about the capital punishment. So this matter is not a light matter, barakallahu. Remember, we study that the deen came to preserve five things. Right? One of them is the nafs, the life of the person, the life of the human being. Now, in general now, not just the life of the Muslim, but the life of the human being, barakallahu feekum. من قتل المعاهد لم يرح ريحة الجنة أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The one that killed the mu'ahid, meaning the one that you have a treaty with, meaning a kafir that has a treaty with the Muslims, whoever kill him will not smell the fragrance of the Jannah. Subhanallah. Huh? Now how about the Muslim, jazakallahu khayran? How about the Muslim making sujood? How about the Muslim being in the masjid? How about the Muslim in the haram? How about the Muslim in the premises of the Kaaba? Now you got the Houthis. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy them and give them what they deserve. Ameen. Launching, what you call those? Missiles, rockets. Towards the Kaaba, towards Mecca. أَحَبُّ الْبُقَاعِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. The most beloved land on this earth to Allah Jalla wa'ala. You don't have nothing better to do than launch some rockets, launch some missiles. That's all you got to do for the place that is the most beloved land to Allah. There is nothing you can do but that. Akhi, that shows wallahi that you are what? You are sick in the heart. You are ill in the brain. No good in you. La khayra fika. You don't have no absolute good in you. Akhi, how a Muslim in their sound mind, you don't got nothing else to do but to point a rocket in the haram. When he was asked the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the most beloved place to Allah? Right? Now there is nothing else you can do but to launch rockets, right? In the haram, in Mecca, in the Kaaba, around the Kaaba. That's the only good thing you have to do. Akhi, clock out and go home. Seriously. If that's the only thing this is the only thing good you can do. So therefore, وعلى القول بتفسيقه, he say, as in regard to the statement of making him a fasiq, he say, قتله حدا. Now, an important point. The first group, right? Those who declare him to be fasiq. They say here, it is that his killing is haddan. His killing is haddan. Wal ma'ana shi'ubayd say, what is the meaning of here? It is hadd. It is annahu yughsal. Annahu yughsal. That he is to be given the ghusl. Yughsal. Right? Meaning the fa'il is? No, the fa'il. The fa'il is not known, but he is to be done. Yughsal. Right? Excuse me. لا أستاذ لا والله لا جزاك الله خير. Don't worry, Abdurrahman. But rather here, if he is killed for the one that they say he's a fasiq, that his killing will be what? A punishment, capital punishment. That does not to mean he's a kafir. But they say fasiq. Shuf, he's a fasiq. Well, fasiq, barakallahu fikum. على النهاية he will enter the Jannah. جزاك الله خير أكرمك الله وبارك فيما بقي من عمرك ومالك زادك الله الحرث على الدين والعلم النافع والعمل الصالح رزقنا الله وإياك بحسن خاتمة. So the Shah حفظه الله تبارك وتعالى, he mentioned here those who say that he is a fasiq, then his killing, the killing of that person will be haddan. will be a capital punishment. Well, ma'ana, in the meaning of it is annahu, that person that abandoned the salah while being in a state of laziness,